Sri Sairam. Say it presents Tapovanam. In this episode, we present Chapter 8, The Lord of the Cosmos, as extracted from the original book titled Tapovanam, Sri Sathya Sai Sathcharithra, written by Sri Jandiala Venkateshwara Shastri. Let us immerse ourselves in listening to the glory of the Lord, Sai Ram. Chapter 8, The Lord of the Cosmos. This play is His, the role is His. The lines are written by Him. He directs, He designs the dress and decoration, the gesture and the tone, the entrance and exit. You have to act the part and receive His approbation when the curtain falls, Baba. All elements lie in His control. The five elements, Panchabhutas, that is, earth, water, light, air and space, are in the total control of Sri Sathya Sai Baba. We will be able to appreciate the veracity of this statement from a few incidents. Rescue from fire. One day, Baba developed a high temperature all of a sudden. It was 104.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Devotees were all perturbed. But happily for them, the temperature came down to 99 degrees Fahrenheit within 5 minutes or so. None of those around him could understand why the temperature rose so abruptly and also came down equally quickly. At about 9:30 p.m., an open-air dinner was arranged on the roof of Swami's residence. The night was cool and pleasant, and there was beautiful moonlight. As everyone was enjoying the meal in the fine atmosphere and the prevailing merriment, Baba turned to a devotee and said, "When you return home tomorrow, caution your mother to be very careful with fire. At the same time, assure her that I will always be with her and protect her from every hazard." Everyone was somewhat taken aback by Baba's words. What made him talk of fire and of future hazards? They pressed Baba to let them know what the matter was. Swami explained, "His mother was praying in her puja room. A number of lighted oil lamps were around her. As she was offering prayers, her sari caught fire without her noticing it. I had to go to her help and put out the flames." Some devotees obtained Swami's permission to make a trunk call to the lady to find out how she was doing. The lady herself answered their call and confirmed the incident. Swami too spoke to her and consoled her, mentioning that it was he who had doused the flames out of compassion for her. But the lady, devout as she was, anxiously inquired, "Swami, while trying to save me, have you burnt your own hands?" He reassured her sweetly, "No, not at all. The flames caused me no harm. Only my temperature went up a little, but soon subsided. Do not worry." Rescue from flood. During the days when Baba stayed in the old temple, Once there were floods in the river Chitravati. The level of the flood waters rose steadily and soon it reached the temple and surrounded it. The situation was quite grim as the water threatened to enter the temple in a few minutes and inundate everything. At that moment, Baba walked into the waters and said, "That's enough. Go back now." Suddenly, the flood began to recede. As described earlier, when for the first time the week-long Veda Purusha Saptaha Jnana Yajnam was performed, devotees thronged the Prashanti Nilayam in thousands. Just when the valedictory offering Purnahuti to Agni, the fire god, was about to commence, the sky became overcast. Massive dark clouds coupled with thunder and lightning threatened to bring about a heavy downpour. The present-day auditorium had not yet been built then, and the vast gathering assembled under the open sky had no shelter whatsoever. If it rained, the whole program would come to a standstill. People were growing restless at the disturbing prospect. Noticing their anxiety, Baba assured them, "Don't worry, there will be no rain." In a little while, the dark clouds cleared. The Purnahuti went on as scheduled and was duly completed without a hitch. Water turns into petrol. Once when Baba was going to Bangalore by car, a little ahead of the town of Chikbalapur, the vehicle stalled as the petrol ran out. There was no filling station anywhere near. Baba asked for water to be brought from the nearby pond. When it was brought in a container, he dipped his hand in the water and stirred it a little. He then asked the driver to fill the petrol tank with the water so treated. The engine sparked to life and the journey was completed without a problem. On another similar occasion, Baba, accompanied by a group of devotees, visited Aurangabad and Ellora in Maharashtra and was proceeding by car to Hyderabad in Andhra Pradesh. On the way, the car stopped for want of fuel. At that time, petrol dealers were on a statewide agitation and went on strike, and there was no way to replenish the tank. Bhagavan just ordered the car, "Run," and it started to run. After reaching Hyderabad, Baba told Sri Kasturi, "Kasturi, without a single drop of fuel, we had to cover 150 miles. What to talk of petrol? Not even water was available on the way this time to fill the fuel tank. We saw no stream nor pond on the route we traveled by." Sunshine in the Himalayas. We have already read earlier that in June 1961, Bhagavan took his parents and some devotees on a pilgrimage to the holy shrine of Badrinath. Sri Burgula Ramakrishna Rao, the then governor of Uttar Pradesh, also joined the entourage and saw to it that every facility was provided to the pilgrims. The trip from Rishikesh to Badrinath, situated in the higher reaches of the Himalayas where snowfalls are common, and back to Rishikesh was completed in just 7 days. All through that period, the travelers encountered not a single snowfall. On the other hand, there was welcome sunshine. The hospitable sun made the weather comfortable and enjoyable. Local inhabitants noticed this unusual weather and felt happy. The phenomenon was also observed by a number of holy persons engaged in spiritual pursuits at those lonely and inhospitable heights. They guessed quite correctly that a highly distinguished spiritual person must be visiting the region and causing by his presence such agreeable though unseasonal weather. A devotee questioned Bhagavan, "Swami, you eat very little. Your body comprises the five elements, Panchabhutas. Then from where does it derive its potency?" Baba gave a very pithy reply, "The five elements give me no potency. It is I who gives them their potency." Om Sri Sathya Sai Parabrahmane Namaha. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.